Hey, hey, Tinkerers, I'm Nene, and today on Tinkertime, we are going to be making plastic, and on Show Me Your Gut, we're going to be opening up an alarm. Tinkerers, what do you think this is? Kind of a creamy substance. I'm gonna taste it. Milk.
Moo.
Cow's milk. All right, and then here we have a kind of a clear substance. What do you think it is? No, it's not water. Kind of got a very strong smell. I'm gonna try it. Are you ready? Watch my face. Oh, Tinkerers, should we test ingredients by tasting them?
Drinking ingredients may result in sudden, painful death.
No! We definitely should not. But in this case, I knew what they were and that they were safe. So we're okay. So today, I can still taste that vinegar. So today we're going to be making plastic. Now, can you believe that we can actually make plastic out of two ingredients? No, I didn't think you could, but you can. So that's what we're going to do here today. It gets a little bit messy, so you gotta stick with me. All right, so I think we might take this to make some noise in here, all right? So I got my bucket, and what we need is about 1 cup of milk. Now this milk has been warmed up, so it's pretty warm, but not boiling. So if you are a little person, you might need some help with that. Get mum or dad to help you put the milk in the microwave and warm it up. So here we go, we're gonna put about 1 cup worth in. That's 250 mils. You can measure it if you want to be more accurate. And then for the 1 cup of milk, you need 2 tablespoons of white vinegar. All right, so I'm gonna put my about two tablespoons worth in. Again, you can totally measure if you want. And then I'm gonna start stirring it. And if you've got your measurements right, what's gonna happen is the milk is gonna start clumping. Now yes, clumping is a technical term. It is called clumping. Definition, making smudgy bits of plastic all together. So you see that? So what's happening is in the warm milk, the protein's being broken down and it's making these kind of clumps. Now what we need to do, we're gonna stir this continuously for about a minute, which gets a bit boring. So we're gonna go time vortex! And now we are ready to get this plastic out. So I need a slightly bigger bowl. I'm gonna put that there. And you need kind of a strainer, like a tea strainer, because that's gonna catch the clumps as they separate from the liquid. So here we go. I'm gonna start pouring this through, like this. And it is catching the clumps. And you see what we have there, that's gonna make our plastic. And you see all the liquid there, which is probably a mix of the kind of watery substance in the milk and the vinegar. And all we're left with are those clumps. Oh, it's almost a perfect fit. Not much left in there. So now the trick is you have to get all the liquid out. So you do best to kind of squish it through the strainer. And as I squish and push down, more and more of this liquid is coming out. Now this plastic is probably going to take about 2 nights, maybe 3, depending on where you live, to dry out where you live because of what the temperature is like. You know, is it humid? Is it cold? Is there lots of sun? That sort of thing. So when it's completely dry, it's gonna go really hard, and that's when it's truly formed into its plastic state. Now, if you've got some paper towels, that's awesome because that's gonna get the last bits of that liquid out. So here, I'm just gonna fold them over like this, and then I'm going to put the big clump on the paper towel. That's the way. All right, and now with this paper towel, you can get out these last bits of liquid here. And the clumping is really getting super clumpy now. So you can see that all that extra liquid is coming out into the paper towel. And now I'm gonna put it on my board, just like that. So you can see, here we've got our big plastic clump. Can you believe that that was only made from vinegar and milk? And here then you get to, you can do whatever you want with it. I'll show you some I made earlier. Ah, here we go. So here's a few others that I'd already made. Now this is a star. I put a little hole in it using a straw, poked that through. And so now I could tie a ribbon through it and that could become like a Christmas decoration. You can paint these, you can add some food coloring if you want to make them all beautiful and rainbow. This is my dinosaur. Now I made him by using a cookie cutter, stamped it through, and that's what he dried out to. And this I just kind of just rolled into a ball. Not really good for much, except for maybe just, you know, throwing at your brother or sister like that. All right, so I've got my clump here. Need a bit more dry. Squishing with my paper towel. And then as you kind of smush it together, that's when you can start to make shapes with it. So it gets a little bit crumbly, but as you work it together, kind of goes flat. And then whatever shape you leave it in, that's how it's gonna dry out. So the more that you can push it together, the more it's gonna dry out super flat. You can kind of see in the dinosaur, there's a kind of a few little holes in there. It's not a perfect plastic, but considering that we made it with two ingredients, I reckon that is pretty amazing. You could definitely squish some things into it. Use your cookie cutters, make your shapes, or just like I said, squish it up and then just start throwing it at people. Right!
One, two, three, four!
Meow, 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 meow.
Show me your guts.
Today on Show Me Your Guts, we are going to be opening up this thing. Do you know what it is? Kind of rattles. But what happens when I put in this battery?
Oh, that's annoying.
Yeah, that's right. This is an alarm clock. So we're going to be opening up, seeing what's inside. At the moment, you can see that it sits on a bedside table, makes those beepy sounds as we change it. Oh! And look at this one. Can you see that? It's kind of lighting up a green color, a red color. Yeah. So it would glow in your bedroom at nighttime. But once I'm through with it, it ain't gonna be glowing or singing anymore. So the first thing I'm gonna do to show me your guts, I'm gonna take out these batteries. Yeah. Goodbye, alarm clock.
You're never gonna nail it.
Well, that worked. It's tinker time. So there we have it. This part is just a white box.
I got a problem and I don't know how to solve it.
Three, can four, wall shape of a cube.
We'll start working through it, every possible solution.
Tricky, open it
tricky,
up.
Tricky.
Not open me, Nene. I will. I will open you.
Some problems need some.
Someone used a hot glue gun to stick this together.
Try to see what I can do. It's time.
You can kind of replace stuff
it's time
these days rather than fixing things.
To tinker, tinker, thinking all about it. Dare to experiment, figure it out. And if it doesn't work, doesn't matter, cause again I'll try.
Getting inside things, knowing how they work. You might not get it working again. Ooh.
It's tinker time. It's tinker time.
Show me your guts.
One, two, three.
Shh. I think they made this plastic with milk and vinegar. I don't think so.
Meow, meow.
Meow, meow, meow.